This is a production study created by Autodesk to compare common civil and infrastructure workflows when completed with Civil 3D versus being completed in base AutoCAD. In this session, we are looking at drawing production. This workflow includes the following tasks: sheet layout, plan and profile sheet production, cut section sheets, labels relative to sheet, updates and edits, drawing standards. When creating the sheets for planned sheet production, there will be limited paper space to fit the length and profile view height on the sheets. In AutoCAD, it might be useful to use the project data as a way to line up the sheet lengths and limits. To do this, you can copy much of the data, including existing surface contours and proposed project design, into the sheet. In the Layout tab, create viewports that will cover the project distance in each sheet layout. Estimate the length of alignment that will fit into each viewport to set the scale. Once this first sheet is completed, it can be copied and used for the rest of the needed sheet layouts. In Civil 3D, we will set up the template file with a Layout tab that has the measurements and settings we need. This is mostly complete out of the box, and only minor changes should be needed, such as title block or specific scales. Save the template file and it is ready for use in the sheet creation process. Plan and profile sheet production will use the sheet layout from the above task. In AutoCAD, you will create layout tabs for each of the expected sheets needed to cover the project extents. In the sheet, unlock the plan viewport and profile viewport and navigate them over the appropriate data in the project. In Civil 3D, you will simply be using the template file layout tab during the plan and profile sheet creation process. First, run the Create View Frames tool, which will create frames indicating how much alignment will appear on each sheet. Once these frames are in place, you can run the Create Sheets from Frames tool, which will then create the layout tabs based on the template layout tab that you created in the previous step, and center the data on the frames that were just created. Only minor tweaks to the layout tabs are needed, including cleaning up the title block area and perhaps some tweaks to the profile viewport. Section sheets display section views in station order for the construction team to check the design along the project. These sheets usually hold more than one view per sheet, depending on depth at each station shown. In AutoCAD, you can copy the section views from the design file as long as they are up to date with the design and paste them into the plan production cross-section sheet file. Create layout tabs for each sheet needed, depending on how many cross-sections are being created. Unlock and navigate viewports in each sheet to display the section views. Repeat this process for each cross-section sheet. In Civil 3D, you will want to data shortcut reference the alignment, surface, and corridors. This will ensure dynamic updates when revisions take place. Create sample lines along the alignment, then create multiple section views to display the sample data. Use the Create Section Sheet tool to identify the section views that were placed and create the sheets. There are labels that need to be added to plan production and section sheets to indicate what is displayed in the sheet. In AutoCAD, you can place multi-line text with an annotative text style for some of these notes. Calculate and add profile slope labels where necessary. Add curve labels to include start and length of curve stations. Place offset labels at breakpoints at each section view. Also, place any other miscellaneous notes in the profile and cross-section sheets. Remember, these labels are not dynamic and will not update during the revision process. In Civil 3D, most of the labels that we would need are already in place in profile and section views. You may need to add miscellaneous notes such as existing ground versus proposed ground, among others, in the profile views and section views. Projects inevitably require revisions and changes as design is reviewed. Design requirements may be found outside of code or other design options pursued, forcing changes to the design. In AutoCAD, since the objects are not dynamic, this will require nearly an entire redesign and redrafting of the project, including alignment recreation and labeling, profile and labeling, cross sections, corridor sampling and redesign, as well as any pipe network and plan and profile views. In Civil 3D, changes to design objects generally update other design elements downstream, including surfaces, alignments, profiles, cross sections, and pipe networks. This further includes labeling for these objects updating to display new information. Maintaining drawing standards starts with using the correct template file. A template file will start a drawing file with the proper layers, line types, text styles, among other settings. This affects the AutoCAD as well as Civil 3D project files. Civil 3D also brings a list of settings, including object styles and label styles, to the file as well. In both cases, starting with a template file will ensure proper standardization in your project files. This has been a look at comparative workflows between Civil 3D and Base AutoCAD for drawing production.